Hi friends, my name is Abhilash. Today we are going to study about photosynthesis. In our earlier classes, we have studied about photosynthesis. But now we are going to study about photosynthesis deeply. What is photosynthesis? Can we define photosynthesis? Yes, we can define photosynthesis. A photosynthesis is a process by which plants contain a green pigment, chlorophyll, and build up a complex organic one with a simpler inorganic one by using sunlight as energy. And photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is nothing but a plants contain a green pigment, chlorophyll, and build up a complex organic one by using sunlight as energy. Now let me explain mechanism of photosynthesis. In the photosynthesis, there are two kind of reactions. Light-dependent reaction and light-independent reaction. Now, let's go through the light-dependent reaction. Light-dependent reaction is also called as photochemical pass. This light-dependent reaction takes place at the daytime. The chlorophyll get activated by exposing to the sunlight by absorbing the photons. Photons are the smallest unit of light energy. Okay? Now, this photon energy or sunlight energy is used to split down the H2O molecule into H plus and OH minus ions. These H plus and OH minus ions are highly reactive. They will undergo a series of changes. Now, let's talk about H plus ion. H plus ion and OH minus ion. OH minus ion undergoes a series of changes and finally it produces oxygen and water. Water is used by the plant inside and O2 is released into the atmosphere. And H plus ion undergoes a series of changes in the dark reaction. And after the photolysis, photolysis is a process by splitting of the water molecule. Okay, this H plus molecule is picked up by the a special compound NADP to form NADPH. What is the NADPH? NADPH is nothing but reduced nicotinamide adenosine dinucleotide phosphate. This is a special compound. And ADP and IP also is a special compound which takes place in the right reaction and they will trap the energy to form ATP. ATP is nothing but adenosine triphosphate. Okay, adenosine triphosphate. At the end of the light reaction, there are only two molecules remaining, two compounds remaining. They are ADP and NADPH. These are called as assimilatory powers. Light independent reaction is also called as biosynthetic pass. In the light independent reaction, the hydrogen from NADPH is used to combine with CO2 by utilizing ATP molecule and form glucose. Glucose is nothing but C6H12O6. In the process, there are many intermediary compounds. Example, the main example for that is RuBP. RuBP, ribulose 1,2,5 bisphosphate, is an intermediary compound which accepts the CO2 in the process. Finally, the glucose is turned into the starch and the plant take out the starch and utilize it. In the whole process of photosynthesis, sunlight plays an important role. Now, let's do an experiment to understand the role of sunlight in the photosynthesis. This is a discharged plant. Do you know how to discharge the plant? It have mentioned in the activity 1. Keep the plant in a dark room for a 1 week. Then it will lose its starch. Then it is a discharged plant. Cover one of its leaf with black paper on which a design is cut. Fix the paper on the leaf in such manner that light does not enter the dark part. Place this potted plant in the sunlight. After few hours of exposure to bright sunlight, test the leaf which is covered by black paper for the presence of starch. You will observe that the plant part which is exposed to the sunlight will become blue-black in color and which is kept under the black paper will be pale in color. By this, we can conclude that the sunlight plays a key role in photosynthesis.
If you want like this important activities information, please subscribe my channel Mallesh Kirishetty. Thank you everybody.